If you're familiar with the concept of suspense in React, you might know that suspense will render the loading if and only if the component itself, which is the child of the suspense, is in a loading state. And by loading, it means, first of all, the component itself should be of type promise. It should return a promise. And if it's not resolved yet, suspense will assume that the component's status is in the suspended mode. So it falls back to the loading state. It's very handy when we want to show a kind of loading while our component is getting ready under the hood. We have the same situation here in the Next.js. It means that we have a page and it's an async function. It means we are returning kind of promise and we are resolving, and we can have function calls with await. But while we are awaiting something, we are putting the users, the end users, on hold until we finish rendering the whole page. And this might not be the best user interface that we can offer to the users. Let's try to show an example how we can put the users on hold. So if I have this code, I'm awaiting a promise that will be resolved after a second or after 5 seconds, let's say. I try to refresh my page and you see that it's waiting. We are waiting for something that we could show at least some loading to the end users instead of putting them on wait. And this also affects SEO. If I take a look into the network tab, you can see if I refresh, it's in the pending status and after 5 seconds will be resolved. Let's take a look into timing. I have to zoom a little bit out. And now I go to the timing. You can see probably I have to make it bigger. Yes, here you can see waiting for the server response is taking 5 seconds, which is not good. We want to reduce this and eventually get a better time to first byte and first painting to the end users. That really affects on the web vitals and our page ranking on search engines. So to do so, what we can do, we cannot simply wrap the page with the suspense, but instead there's another file naming convention in Next.js called loading. So next to our page, similar to error, we can have some other kind of files called loading.tsx. Again, we can have JSX or JS as well. So I go with TSX because I want to have TypeScript and JSX syntax. What I have to return, I should simply return export default function. I call it carrier loading. Sounds good. And then instead of this, let me just simply return a simple dev loading. And now if I try to refresh, let's try. It's not hitting because I removed that code that was causing suspension. Let's bring it back. Now I'm putting the carrier page in a suspended mode. And as soon as Next.js sees these kind of things, actually it is React behavior, not from Next.js. As soon as it sees this kind of suspension, it tries to render the loading for us instead. Let's try to refresh. And as you can see, for 5 seconds, we are seeing this loading. And then after it gets resolved and the return happens, eventually our page will be rendered and will generate some output to the end users. And the loading will be replaced with the actual page, with the actual data that we receive. It is the best place to show some kind of skeleton to the users. Let's try to have one. For skeletons, of course, there are tons of libraries out there you can use to simulate the UI that you have with a skeleton, with the loading, to prevent and reduce the content shifting, which is a negative point if you have a lot of content shift on your web page. So let's try to refresh and you see it's showing a skeleton instead of that simple loading text. Let's try again. I close this. And it's a better UI and it has less content shift on our page. So basically it is the best place to implement a skeleton with a better UI. So end users will expect what kind of content it's going to show them. And final thought about the loading itself. You might ask what kind of situations causes the page to go into the suspended status. This code that I have written is an example, of course, but in a lot of cases you want at your page level, you want to fetch some data, maybe from an API. Maybe you have an API, you want to get some data from that API, and then you have to wait for this API to be fetched. Then you use this data to render something, right? So by using this await, we are putting the page on the suspended mode. Or even maybe you are working with a database and you want to do database operations. Maybe you have a database somewhere and this I show a snippet code like here, maybe you want to connect to the database, and then maybe you want to query some data from the database like this, and you want to have this await at the top level, and this behavior will put your page on the suspended mode. And since it's suspended and we are using loading, Next.js using React will wrap our page with the suspend and show a fallback, which is loading itself. So that was it from loading and how to use it. And I hope now you know how to work with that. See you in the next ones.